Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Today, our ESCOM live session will present about the P delta effect by Dr. Pramin Narachan, who is the senior structural engineer from AT Solution. This topic has been requested from many users. So now we're going to start. Okay, Dr. Pramin, please start.
Okay, thank you, Khun Kitty, and hello, everyone. So let me share the screen first. Khun Kitty, I could not share the screen. Hello, Khun Kitty.
You cannot share. You don't have the button.
I have, but wait. Let me check. Host disable participant screen sharing. Did you disable something?
Okay. I'm sharing
now. Oh, now I be able to open.
Okay. They just switch off.
Oh, okay. I think should be okay now. And okay. So let me setting something. Okay, let me start now. This training topic is regarding to the P delta effect in ETAP. Okay. Actually before this training, I already did the previous training. In SAP 2000 regarding to the geometric nonlinearity. That one also will contain more theory background and more detail about the P delta also. I just recommend those who never see that training, you can back after this training, you can back to see also to get more idea. Okay, let me start now. If we have cantilever beam structure, this one, and if we put the load here at the top, yes, we will get the response. Response can be displacement, can be internal force. If we put the force here in this axis and we put the response here, displacement here. Okay, when we increase the load, actually we thought that the behavior should be linear like this, right? But in reality, when you increase more load, it will be nonlinear response. And the structure will be nonlinear response. For this one, what is called the structure to be the nonlinearity? They have basic source of the nonlinearity, two basic source, two main basic source. First, we call geometric nonlinearity. This is the effect of the deformation. It can be bucking effect. It can be P delta effect. And it also can be large displacement effect regarding to the deformation. The second one can be material nonlinearity. This is the effect of the material property. It can be cracking in concrete, catching in concrete, yielding in steel, keep or shrinking, that it will be time dependent. Both of them we put to the our structure. So you can expect that your structure, your structural response under the really large load will be nonlinear behavior as well. Okay, so what is the geometric nonlinearity that regarding to the effect of deformation, such as column bucking? When you put the load vertically, when it leaves the critical load, it will have a lateral displacement like this. This is a seem to be like a third member. This is a tension and this is a compression member. It's the same thing when it gets the tension with the slenderness slender member, it will have the lateral bucking as well. And the other one, this one is a thin cylindrical shell. For this one, under the really large load, because it really thin structure, it can have the local bucking as well. This is some sample of the bucking. it's a part of the geometric nonlinearity. The other example is when we have the pin-pin column, for example, and we have some small asymptic. In case that asymptic, this one becomes zero, we try to make sure the load here, and we try to make sure the lateral displacement as well. We plot the load here and displacement here. So in case that asymptic become to zero, the force will increase until it reach the critical load that is like bucking, and then it suddenly jump. If we have the small asymptic that we provide some small imperfection in here, you get this part with a small asymptic. If you provide really large asymptic, you get this part. You can see the load and the displacement here is not linear anymore. It's a non-linear behavior. The other example will be the this structure, the arc structure. When you put the load here, we try to move it downward here, like a disc shape, put it down more and more and more. And then we try to monitor the load here. If we plot the displacement here, the vertical displacement here, and if we plot the load that we monitor, we get a solid line like this. Actually, we thought that it should be linear. Actually, the reality, it will not be linear. It will be non-linear. Okay, these are some sample of the effect from the geometric nonlinearity. Okay, so we move to this structure to provide you more idea about the P delta also. That is one part of the geometric nonlinearity. If we have the cantilever structure column like this, that receive the load vertically and horizontally like this. In case that we have really small displacement here, you can take the equilibrium, get the bending moment here. The bending moment will be capital H multiplied with small h, you will get bending moment here. At the undeformed position, the concept of P delta, they will take the equilibrium based on the partial deformed position. What is the partial deformed position? They account only horizontal, they not account the vertical displacement. Okay, the additional moment that you get from P multiplied with delta here. For the last one, they try to account for the actual position. This one we call last displacement. Actual deformation, we have the laterally, and then you have the vertical also. You need to update for the height to get the actual length. So this one will be the most accurate to calculate the response of the structure. This will be the approximation method. This item is not account any geometric nonlinearity. So in the normal building, if the dip approximately 10%, it actually is sufficient to use P delta. Okay, this is a basic idea. And we move more for the P delta effect. If we have cantilever column under the vertical and horizontal load. First, horizontal load, you provide the big delta that's related to the global of the structure, the big delta. And the axial load here, P, also generate the small delta that we call bucking of the member as well. So it consists of both terms. For the first term, for the H, it creates this moment. For P delta, it generates additional moment here, P delta. And then for the local bucking, here, for the local, if you create this part of bending moment. So this structure is quite simple. It deform under the single curvature. You can see they have the effect of the small delta as well, based on the single curvature. But for the generally building, the column, normally if you deform under the double curvature, when it deform in the double curvature, the P, the small delta, it seems to be very small or equal to zero. So in terms of the P delta small, it can be ignored, but it still have the big delta here also. Okay, and we move to this one. We also, in our structure, we have both vertical element and horizontal element. Horizontal element can be beam. Vertical element will be column. For horizontal element, if you have no axial load, if you have no, they have no any P delta effect, but in case that you have axial load, like a P step, you will possible to have the P and the small delta here. For column, Column, we have both global big delta and small delta also. It's the different thing. That means it will affect more in the column for the P delta effect. Okay, we move back to ETAP. What option that ETAP provide to us that we can pay for the include geometric nonlinearity parameter? First, you can check for the bucking using eigenvalue. This one try to find the critical load. The second one, you can use this bucking. You can switch to here. You can choose the option of the nonlinear static also or nonlinear dynamic. But on this one, you can further select another three. Non-mean not include P delta. The second is include P delta. And the last one, P delta path displacement, is the same one that I showed you previously. They have three options, the small displacement, P delta, and large displacement. And ETAP also further provide you another option that they call preset P delta option. In preset P delta option, they provide three options. None that means you not include P delta. And then the second one is non-iterative. Based on mass, this one will not use any actuality. They use some simple way to provide you P delta effect. But the most accurate one, it will be actuality based on the load, this one. Okay, that means they have any option for you. So in this training, I will try to show all options to you as well. And what is the different result between them, okay? So if we move to see the preset P delta option, this is the main option that we will see today. How to use this one? You can go to define P delta option, and then you can see dialog box of P delta option. In here, you can specify the gravity load based on the combination, okay? We will talk more about detail this one. Okay, whenever you provide P delta option, preset like this, it will perform first before other case. It will run first. Before you run linear static, before you run model analysis, response spectrum and time history, it will run first. And then when you create the load pattern, you will automatically get the load case. In the load case, if you perform P delta first, it will use the modified SIGNET for the P delta case here. If you modify the SIGNET, use the initial modification. If you don't use this one, it will use the zero SIGNET, start from the zero SIGNET. And for preset P delta here, it not affect to the nonlinear static because nonlinear static also they have their own P delta. And really important thing and strongly recommend before you use preset P delta, you need to check your model first in linear analysis to check the correctness. Preliminary model just run linear. It should not have any warning and error. Otherwise, you cannot run, or when you run, you get the warning also. And actually, preset P delta also can detect the bucking also. In case that they have, you put very, you provide very small structure member, the program might stop if you include the P delta here and not report you any result. Okay. Based on two options here, based on math and no iterative and iterative based on load. For the non-iterative based on math, it will be based on math for each four. They not require any iterative. That means it will be very fast for this option. But it's not really good when you use in case that they have the specific gravity load. Like when you have the load combination. Mass is not load combination, like it's a pure mass. When you have the load combination, it's better to use the second option. The second option is iterative based on locate. This one needs iterative. That means it non-linear bit, run many times, many times. Okay, this one seem to be more better than this one because you can handle for the load combination as well. And to use this one, okay, they have two main step. First, you click pset pdelta and provide the vertical load here. Okay, and then when you see the load case, it automatically switch to use the modified stiffness from the pset here. In here, if you keep none, it will have nothing here. But now I switch here, it will start the modified stiffness here. And the second step, you need to make the normal load combination. This is a linear static, right? Normal, just combine the load combination at the normal. This is the way to account for the P delta in ETAP also. Okay, so I finished the first part that I just brief simple about the theory regarding to the geometric nonlinearity and P delta option in ETAP as well. And now we move to the second part. This one will be example. The example, I try to go to all of the area of the geometric nonlinearity, include the bucking also and P delta. I start with the bucking, elastic bucking load. When we call elastic bucking, that means we ignore inelastic material property. We ignore the nonlinear material. We just think that it will still be elastic. So to do this one, this one is a only column with the section 0.1 by 0.1. This is a material property and area here. I try to pay many type of support with the same section. This is a fixed support. This one is a pin. This one fixed pin. This one fixed. Okay. Now I do nothing, just try to calculate the critical load that that can be acting to here that generate the bucking load. Based on this one, based on the theory that we studied before, the effective length here will be 2. The effective length factor, this one be 2, this one 1, 0.7, this case will be 0.5. Based on the Euler bucking formulation, you can calculate the critical load. This is the hand calculation. Based on the same section and same dimension, when you change the support, you can see the load that this section can handle it differently. So if you use this case to make the structure for simple, it gets very small load. But in case that if you fix both sides, you can your structure based on the same section can receive more load. It's a 16 times for simple. Okay. This is only calculation. How can we pay by using bucking load option in ETAP? You go to define load pattern, and then I just name bucking, and then you switch the load case type. They have many options. Like you have nonlinear static also. They have the linear static. They have bucking. I click here. Okay, and first I provide the load 1. To get the critical load in ETAP, ETAP will report you the bucking factor lambda. You need to multiply with the load that you apply, you will get the critical load. Now I just apply load 1, okay? And just leave the default value here. Okay, this is the way to click for the bucking analysis. When we see the result, how can we see the result? They have two options. First, you can see the result from the deformed shape. The other one you can see from the show table. From the deformed shape, after you run the analysis, you go to the load case of bucking. And then it will report you the bucking factor here. Bucking factor, you need to multiply back the force that you apply. Now I apply 1, that means this one will be the critical load. Okay, the second one you can see from the display show table and go to analysis result structure output but in false because we use the default in report 6 case you can see the 6 marking loop here. Okay, so to do this model, I just simply model one line and fix support variant for type and I further subdivide the element by using automate to get more accurate result. Okay, the form the result form each tab, the lambda that I get marking factor multiply with fourth one, I get the critical load is for this case I get 6.18. This case, the second case, I get this one, the third one, I get this one, and the last one, I get this one. This is the result from ETAP that report you in terms of the bucking factor and multiply with the load that you apply. And we can compare with the hand calculation that we do before. In here, hand calculation that I do before. You can see it's nearly identical, right? That means we can use ETAP also to find the bucking if you want to find the bucking load in the structure. Okay, if you have the reality of the structure, this is a cylinder, 50 solid building. Okay, this I just apply the load, dead load, and 50% of line load for each four. Okay, I use many mode, run for bucking, many mode. Okay, this I show first mode and fourth mode. This is under deformation, this is axial load. Okay, the first mode they show the bucking factor 3.13. The fourth mode they show 4.59. Sorry. Okay, based on this one, you can see based on the load that we apply, it means that if you buckle in the first mode, approximately T time of this one. You can see our structure have margin approximately T time for the first mode. For the higher mode, actually it's difficult to happen because it might require the really large load. If you apply here, it will bucking in here first. But even three time, it seems to be difficult because it will break based on the material first actually. Okay, that's the first example regarding to the bucking that relate to geometric nonlinearity as well. The second, we move to the P delta of cantilever column. In this case, P delta of cantilever column. The idea is that I try to use P set P delta and nonlinear static as well that include P delta for this example. This one is a cantilever column fixed support here. The section is here 0.3 by 0.3 area here, material property show here. The load apply vertically and horizontally. Before I apply the load vertical here, I just simple calculate for the critical bucking load that it will be maximum load here. But I try to use only 40% of the critical load that approximately 2000 and put 170 in here. Okay. So I just try to check something first. Try to predict the lateral displacement here. The lateral displacement here, in case that not include P delta, I get this one. In case that include P delta, we need to include the geometric stiffness also, I get this one. Okay, this one not include, actually ETAP or SLAP, the formulation in frame, it will include the shear deformation as well. This is a flexural deformation. You can find the stiffness easily actually. And we can find the lateral displacement by invert here, right? Okay, we get this displacement. This is a horizontal force. In when we account for the geometric stiffness also, geometric nonlinearity, this term is a stiffness in terms of the axial load. It be negative because this is a compression, okay? After that, we get a negative stiffness also. And then I try to find the lateral displacement involve geometric nonlinearity as well. And then I find this displacement. You can see when we account for geometric stiffness or geometric nonlinearity, it the displacement is increased because the structure is seem to be more flexible when we account for the axial load as well. Okay, this is a hand calculation, 0.09 and 0.15. Okay, start to do the some comparison now. I use all options. First case will be just linear static. Second case will be nonlinear static, include P delta. Third case will be nonlinear static, include P delta plus large displacement. Okay, to do linear static is normal, but for the nonlinear static, okay, you can go to define load case here and choose the load case type nonlinear static, right? And in here, geometric nonlinearity, it depends on the case. You can use P delta also for the second. This is the third case. I use P delta plus large displacement. Okay, the combination here, I just want to pay some factor. Actually, the example, this one put 2000 vertical and horizontal 150. But in the model, I apply vertical only 1000, horizontal 100. That means we need some factor to multiply to get the total one. This factor I put in here to get the same result. Okay, this is the three case already. And the highlight one is preset P delta. This is another case, the last case. Go to preset P delta option and go to iterate based on load, right? Because we need the vertical two times based on the factor here, put here. Only vertical. And then it will use the modified signet here in the other case. In another case modify here. And in the load combination, you just put the same vertical, combine vertical and horizontal 2 and 1.7 here. There's the technique to use this one. That means I have 4 case. So we shall we see the displacement first weight on 4 case from the normal linear static, nonlinear path, P delta, nonlinear and P delta plus large displacement and P set P delta. For the normal linear analysis, the displacement 0.0913. I do hand calculation also that I show you in the previous slide in here. This is a hand calculation. You can see it's same for here. For this one, quite simple. For the just linear, not account for geometric signet. But when I account, I get this value, right? In term of P delta, they get this one in ETAP. In term of P delta plus large, they get this one. And in term of P set P delta, they get this one. You can see it quite nearly same with the hand calculation also that we calculate before. But in term of when you include P delta, it amplify the displacement from here. To account and not account is different, right? So we do further thing to calculate the bending moment here. This is a hand calculation. For the linear static, if we calculate the bending moment, it will be undeformed position will be here. You will get a 510 undeformed here. But when you check for the P delta, you need to account for P delta as well because this is, will be partial deformed position here. You will get this one. And for the P delta plus large, need to account for vertical also, subtract for the vertical as well. You get this term. For the P set P delta, it's quite the same with this one. Just update for this displacement, you get this one. This is a bending moment that they get. Bending moment also increase in term of when you account for P delta. This is a hand calculation based on the displacement that we obtain. Okay, we can see the bending moment in ETAP as well that they report linear P delta, P delta plus large and P set for other T P delta, you can see it increased from the normal linear analysis, right? And then we can compare the ETAP and simple hand calculation that I just did before here. So it quite same. That means I did this one because we just would like to understand how the program calculate the result for this one. So the conclusion from here, If you use P delta plus large, actually it usefully geometric stiffness, it will take more time to run. This one seems to be simplified approach, but it's still based on nonlinear static. It takes time. This one seems to be the faster time when you run the analysis. And it provides the nearly identical result. Okay, so normally when we design design the building, we need to make the load combination based on the design code. How can we apply the P delta effect in the load combination? Okay, actually they have two concepts to include this one. First, I call the nonlinear static case. Second, it will be initial P delta load case. I compare both SAP and ETAP. Actually, they do the same thing. For the nonlinear static, this one is the most accurate. But the problem is this. You need to run nonlinear static for every case. If you have 10 cases, you need to run nonlinear static for 10 cases. If you have small structure, it will be very fast. But if you have tall building with thousands of elements, it will take really long time for each case. Spend time for this one. The second option, this one is the initial P-delta load case that is a just approximation method. Okay, and then it can applicable for model from the response spectrum for dynamic analysis as well. It requires one time of nonlinear static and use the modified SNET for the other load combination. If you use SAP, you run nonlinear static first, and then you just do the linear static for other. By using the start the stiffness from here, not use the any load from here, just stiffness, modified stiffness from here. ETAP also do the same thing, but they provide this option for you already. They call preset P delta, that is a nonlinear static actually, and then you can use a normal load combination here. Okay, so ETAP implement the same way with SAP 2000. For this one, I recommend you also can back to see the previous training about the SAP 2000 in topic of geometric nonlinearity. Okay, they have more detail also. We move to the last example. This one is P delta with load combination. This is a 50-story RC building. Okay, the dimension. Yeah, you can see. And I would like to monitor the displacement here and monitor the moment here also at the bed. Okay, I try to generate two cases based on this load combination. First case, we just do normal load combination, just combine without P delta. The second case, we try to do nonlinear static, include P delta. But this case, if you have 10 cases or 20 cases, you have to run all nonlinear static. The last one, I will use preset P delta. Okay. For the last one, when we select preset P delta, we need to provide the set of the cavity first. Which case that we will choose to be the preset of P delta? You see the your load combination first. It will be something like a conservative approach. In this case, I select the case number 3 or either number 5, that's account for only gravity. And they have the lateral load here. I use this one to use for the preset gravity load P delta here. You might argue that why don't we use this one? This one doesn't have the lateral load. It will not have the P delta effect. That's why I choose this one. They have the lateral load also. Okay. And we will mainly focus on only this case. Only this case. Show you the idea. The first case, just do normal load combination, right? Not include any P delta. Just do the combination. In this one, they have super dead load as well. Just do normal load combination. The second case, this is a nonlinear static P delta. non-linear static here, P delta here, and make the combination here. The third case, I switch to use PZP delta iterative back on load. This you need to provide only with cavity load. Cavity load here. Yeah. Okay. And then later on you can do the load combination, put the same thing. Because it will not be double, it just use the modified signet here. It not use the load. Okay, the load still be here. Just modify signet from here. Okay, we have TK, we compare the replacement first. This is a normal load combination, P delta and PZP delta. The defection at this point for the normal load combination based on this one, I get 1.63. And when we use nonlinear static, I get 2.07. It increased approximately 1.3 times for this structure. I use PZ, P delta, I got 2.08. It's nearly same with the nonlinear static. This one the most accurate now. But you use the simplified approach, you still get the quite same result. Okay, this term of the deformation. Next we move, next we move to see in term of the fault also. I move to see the column bending moment from the bed. And this is the beam. Okay, because they have the end offset, right? That the bending moment show only this area. This is a normal load combination. This is a P delta nonlinear. This is a PZ P delta. You can see that for the P delta and PZ P delta, the load quite same. But it different from the linear. Normal linear combination. This one and this one is different approximately 1.1 until 1.3 for this structure. That it amplify the bending moment based on this structure. So we need to include the P delta also to get more load for the design because they have the effect of the P delta. Okay, we move to the last part like this. For the design code, actually they require us to use the second order P delta effect. That means second order actually it includes both big P delta for gobo and small P delta here for the account for the bucking here. They require both, but the program do the good job to capture the big P delta because you use one element line with two nodes. But for this one, they cannot perform for you based on the NICIP. If you want it to capture this one, you need to break the element to use many elements. It can capture this defection also in the NICIP. But when you break the element, you can imagine that every four, you need to break the column. It will increase the number of elements. The gobo signet will be very large. It will take more time for NICIP also. So they have the other option. Actually we want to get the total bending moment here. Okay. The first bending moment, we can get from the analysis by model only one element with two nodes. This one it can capture the P big delta based on the lateral load. We can call gobo or we can call sway. Yeah. Based on this term, the program will always set B equal to 1. Sway, delta sway or equal to 1. Assume that you always use P delta. It assumes like that. Okay. The second term, they call small delta here. To account for here, you can get from the design, not analysis. When you run the design, based on the code, they will try to calculate further about the non-sway factor here that you might familiar this formulation. And it relates to the Euler bucking here based on the column, okay? To amplify the bending moment here, right? So that means you can capture now both from the global and local as well. But if you want to capture the global, because it always said to be one, you need to always consider the P delta effect in the analysis before running the program. Otherwise, it will not account for this one for you. Okay. That's all. I think it's suitable time as well. I think at least it's just some basic idea. Your work will be more complicated, but I hope this one will provide you some benefit about the basic idea. Okay, thank you. So,
okay, thank you, Dr. Bamin. So now we are clear and understand what is different from linear analysis, non-linear with P delta and also P delta with large assessment. And the last one is a present P delta, which is available only ETAP. Anyone has a question? You can chat or you can turn on your mic. So you can try by yourself, right, with using the simple model, like a one cantilever, and you can see the difference and you can have the calculation.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, for the first part, I think we're going to share this video, right, so you can watch later, because we record this video.
Okay, if okay.
Okay, one more. Oh, that one is just dummy value.
Oh, this one actually like this. I just that is some sample that I set by myself to show you the way to pay the factor. It that doesn't be based on the cost. You can pay any factor to check that. When you switch the factor, it can also applicable. It not related to any design code. Yeah. I think it related to this one, right? Yeah, this one is I record. Let me show you. It's not this one is not this not the design code. I just want to get the total one, this one, and then I just want to pay with some factor. That's just some example to pay with the factor. That's all. Not the based on the design code.
Any question? So we record the video, right, and we will upload to YouTube. And when we have a next announcement in email, please check at the bottom of email, right? I will put link, not only the video, and also we put the presentation also, and together with the model, so you can download and study again and again. Okay. So any question?
For more information, you can back to practice the sample that I provide in this training also to provide you more idea and try to pay all. You will understand more that how it works. That's the idea. Try to pay something with simple first, because if you start with something that complicated, it's difficult to interpret the result. there's just some recommendation.
So any question? Okay, so if no question, I will end this section. Thank you very much for Dr. Mamin.
Yes, okay.
See you in next section.
Okay, thank you everyone for watching this one. Okay, thank you.